In this lesson, we will learn how to use Excel's built-in functions. For your convenience, Excel contains many built-in functions. Functions are invoked by typing the function name followed by its arguments listed in parentheses. Functions take the arguments as input and calculate a single value. Many of the common math functions only have one argument. For example, sin, parentheses x, takes a number, called x here, as input and calculates the sine of that number. Cos, parentheses x, calculates the cosine of x. Sqrt, parentheses x, calculates the square root of x. Exp, parentheses x, calculates e raised to the power of x. Ln, parentheses x, calculates the natural logarithm of x. And log 10, parentheses x, calculates the base 10 logarithm of x. There are many other built-in mathematical functions as well. It's important to remember that trigonometric functions require the argument to be in radians, not degrees. There also are built-in functions that can calculate statistics. These functions require multiple arguments. Two of the most common statistical functions are average and stdev, which calculate the mean and standard deviation of a set of numbers. Here is an example of how to use Excel's built-in functions. Cells A2 through A6 have values stored in them. In cell B1, we can calculate the square root of 9 by typing equals sqrt and then a 9 inside parentheses, and we obtain 3. The function name is not case sensitive, and you can type the function name using any combination of upper and lowercase letters. In cell B2, we can calculate the natural logarithm of A2 by typing equals ln A2. In cell B3, we can calculate the base 10 logarithm of A3 by typing equals log 10 A3. In cell B5, we can calculate the sine of A5 by typing equals sine A5 in parentheses. And we get a number that is close to zero because 3.14 is very close to pi. In cell B6, we can calculate the cosine of A6 by typing equals cosine A6. And we obtain the value 1, which is the cosine of 0. We can calculate the average value of the numbers stored in A2 through A6 by using the average function. In cell D3, type equals average 1, 10, 2, 3.14, and 0, each separated by a comma. In this case, we have 5 arguments, and each argument is separated by a comma. The average of those 5 numbers is 3.228. We also could use cell addresses to refer to the numbers. In cell D4, we will type equals average A2, comma A3, comma A4, comma A5, comma A6. So again, we have 5 arguments, and when we hit enter, we obtain the same result as before. Often you will want to calculate the average of many cells, and manually typing every cell address can be very time consuming. If the cells are next to each other, you can use a shortcut. In cell D5, we type equals average A2 colon A 6. The argument list consists of the first cell and last cell we want to take the average of, separated by a colon. And this command will calculate the average of all cells between A2 and A6. The standard deviation of cells A2 through A6 can be calculated using the stdev function. So in cell D6, we type equals stdev A2 colon A6.